Yo, what up, it's Don.
Sammy Lee here.
Soul Brothers back up in it. Performing review.
Yes.
Why not 0.2?
Yes.
Russell, by Jordan Brand.
By Jordan Brand, Russell Westbrook's second signature shoe.
Wessel Russbrook.
Yes. So, let's get it started. Right off with the trash. Now, you have half circles. That it was a very interesting, you know, pattern when I first saw it. I was like, it looks actually pretty good. Circles are multi-directional, you know, and the grooves are very deep and the rubber is super soft, so I feel like it's gonna be good. Is it good? It's freaking awesome, man. Ooh. Like, okay, so on the clean court, you're gonna be stopping on a dime, dude. You stop really, really hard, no issues at all. It's just like one of the best stops that I've ever had in a shoe, you know, like, almost as hard as like the Kyrie 2, you know, Kobe 9, D-Rose 7. It's on that level, you know. That's how good the rubber compound is, and I guess the outsole design. On dust though, it's weird. So on dust, it does pick up dust, right? But it's pretty easy to wipe off because it doesn't really trap dust. So it just kind of gets stuck on these little circle things, and you just do a light wipe and it's good to go. But if you don't have time to wipe, you know, and it's like a long play or whatever, you don't have time to wipe, the lateral stop is not very good.
Mm.
You know, only when there's a lot of dust buildup. You know, right. So like it is easy to wipe off the dust, which is good, really good for dust. But if there's a little bit too much dust buildup, then for lateral stops, it's not gonna be that good. But on like, I guess, going forward, it's really good.
Right.
Really weird. I don't know why that happens, but that's what happened to me. But just a little minor gripe, you know, if you let the dust build up a little too much, you know? But just consistently wiping, you're gonna be good to go on dust. Outdoor courts, hell no.
This shit is crazy.
Dude, look
soft.
At this, man. They're so
they're already popping off.
Yeah, so it's really soft, first of all. Very, very pliable rubber. So I feel like they should have made the circles a little bit more, you know, a little bit thicker. But I don't know, is it? Yeah, see? Like peeled off right here.
Yeah.
And that's just from indoor use. And right here, you see that?
Yeah, it's fraying a little bit.
Yeah, and that's just from indoor use, man. I don't know what's up with that. Companies need to start making some harder rubber, more durable outsoles, man. That's crazy.
Yeah.
But, so durability, I don't think is going to be good, especially on outdoor court. Don't play with these at all on outdoor court. And, it's ripping off a little bit. It kind of sucks.
Yeah.
But if you're not, I don't think it's as bad as the Curry 6s. But it's still pretty bad, so just watch out for that. But just performance on traction, really, really good with these, man. I love these. So there's that. Moving on to the cushion. The cushion, of course, you have a midfoot shank, this yellow. Eric said it looks like a ravioli.
Yeah, it does look
kind of looks like a ravioli, yeah. So you have that plastic midfoot shank. The cushion is Phylon or injected Phylon or whatever. But it's actually really nice in the heel. You know, it's pretty damn soft. And there is a good amount of heel compression. Like, not as crazy as Boost or, like, React or something. But it's nice, especially for, like, a Phylon. So, I like that in the heel. You have a large volume zoom in the forefoot. I think it's... correct me if I... We haven't seen what's inside the shoe yet. But, you know, I feel like it is the same size as the Jordan 32. 4 foot zoom unit, which is a large, like really big unit.
Mm-hmm.
So I like that, how that feels. Really didn't need to break it in. It feels crazy, feels super bouncy. So yeah, I like that in the 4 foot. And also I really like the shape of the outsole, you know, especially how it curves up like this.
Yeah.
You know, it really helps for that heel to toe transition, you know, like in the 0.1 or like shoes that have an edged out, very flat outsole, that just slaps the floor. And you know, it feels really clunky, and I just don't like how it feels, you know. But this really smooths it out. It makes, when you play the game, you know, it makes it a lot smoother. So I really like that as well. And I didn't really notice anything from the decoupled midsole or decoupled outsole. You know, like, you know, you sometimes, like in the Jordan 28 and 29, I didn't like how it felt because it kind of felt like it was going like this while I was playing. But I didn't have any issues there. It's a really nice cushion setup, top cushion setup. The only thing I didn't like about it is the court feel isn't very good. Court feel, you feel pretty high off the ground. Not as crazy as LeBron's 16 and stuff like that, but definitely not as good as like the Curry's or Harden's. I would say somewhere in between, but Chord Fuel still isn't very good. So if you like a lot of Chord Fuel, you're not gonna get it here. But impact protection is really good, heel to toe transition is really good. I like that really nice bounce in the forefoot, and just a really nice cushion setup for me, besides I guess the Chord Fuel. So there's that. Moving on to the materials.
Whoa.
Yeah.
There's a lot going on. This looks like carbon fiber.
It does look like carbon fiber.
It's just like some threaded fiber on the side, these like wing panels.
You have a very nice knit material. You see that black part?
Yeah.
I like that. Why don't they just use that, you know? But I'm not mad at this, you know, mesh material in the forefoot.
Yeah, that's cool.
It's really nice. It's a little stiff at first, but it's really soft now. Conforms to your foot really well. See how soft that is, guys? So it's really thin too, but it's supportive, it's not stretchy at all. And yeah, overall materials is actually really nice, you know?
Yeah, it looks crazy. It's a lot of different paneling of different materials, but...
Yeah, so materials, A1. Not A1, but like as far as like quality goes, but it feels really nice on foot. So not mad at it at all. Moving on to the fit. The fit is really nice for me. It fits pretty damn narrow, so watch out if you're a wide footer. And the toe box is pretty damn tight as well. So watch out if you're a thick, wide footer. But for me, it was perfect. I love the fit of this shoe. And putting it on is actually kind of annoying. At first, it was really annoying because, you know, it's not broken in or anything. So I had to, like, use my finger as kind of like a shoehorn.
Yeah.
Because this part does come in.
This is weird.
Yeah,
it has like there's like two layers in the ankle.
That's too much, man.
It's too much.
It makes it bulky, which we'll get into. But once I broke it in, and you know, material stretched out, it got easier to put on. So not a huge deal, not a huge issue. But I would have liked it to have this inner booty come up a little bit more for a heel tab, you know. But anyways, there's that. Moving on to support and lockdown. Support and lockdown is awesome. You have this, I guess, material here, which kind of comes into the eyelet, and you also have this strap containing you, and also you have the midsole coming up a lot, you know, so that's really good in the forefoot area. You have this red part, which is, you know, just an external TPU heel counter, and the foam that's come up in the heel too. So lateral pathemic, your lockdown. It is a mid, but it didn't really feel like a lot of ankle support as far as like, you know, if you want like ankle restriction, you're not gonna get it here, you know? It felt more of like a low, which wasn't bad for me, but if you're looking for ankle like protection,
rigidity,
I guess like restriction, then you're not gonna get it here. But of course you can always wear an ankle brace with this. I feel like it'll be nice. But yeah, overall the shoe is really, really supportive, but it is not very wide. There's really no outrigger.
Yeah.
So I did...
And it kind of rounds a little bit too, the outsole.
Exactly. So I didn't roll my ankle or anything, but I just felt a little bit of rolling while I was playing, you know, especially when I was doing a stop like this. So I would have liked it if the base was a little bit, you know, wider. Also because the court feel isn't very good. You know, you're kind of high off the ground. But just a little minor gripe. I didn't have any issues with it. Just saying that I feel like it would have been a little better if it was wider. Moving on to the weight. These are gonna be kind of heavy, dude. 14.3 ounces. Yeah, that is pretty damn heavy for my shoes. Does it feel heavy? Yeah, it feels kind of heavy on foot. Bulky, not as much. You know, the 0.1s was super bulky. I hated it, but like, it doesn't feel too bulky. I like the forefoot and stuff like that, and the midsole doesn't feel very, very chunky or anything. I guess like a little bit here, but you don't really feel that, you know? But I just don't like how there's two layers of material, like this inner booty with this. I don't think that was the best choice if you want to make a lighter shoe, but you know, I guess it adds for more support and like padding and stuff like that, which I think Westbrook does like. But yeah, is it responsive? Yeah, really responsive cushion. You feel really, really fast on your feet, especially with that 4 foot zoom unit. Traction is really good. The fit and support from the materials is also really good. So you're gonna feel really fast and light on your feet when you're playing in it. It just feels a little heavy. You know what I'm saying? Not the lightest feeling shoe. So there's that. Moving on to the comfort. Very, very comfortable shoe. If you're gonna be casually wearing this, you know, I love this. I just love heel striking and just walking like this because it's just a nice heel to toe transition. 4 foot zoom is very comfortable and the materials are also really comfortable. So yeah, you're gonna be really, really comfortable walking around in this. Braking time, nothing to break in. Traction is good right out the box. I felt the cushion right away. Materials are a little stiff, but it, you know, like a day or two, it's gonna be broken in, gets really soft. So braking time, not too long, really, really good right out the box.
Durability?
Durability, the shoe seems really, really durable besides the outsole. I mean, I do have chunks of the rubber that are fraying off a lot, and also some of it did rip off, especially where the ball of my foot is. That's where you put a lot of torque, a lot of pressure when you're playing that football, you know? So durability from the outsole doesn't seem like it's gonna be the best, which kind of sucks. But other than that, everything else seems pretty good.
How was ventilation?
Ventilation was pretty warm. You know, the materials are kind of thick and there's really no ventilation holes or anything, and not a lot of airflow throughout the shoe. So yeah, it was pretty warm.
Aesthetics.
I like these,
bro. I think they're pretty dope.
I love these, dude. I just love how not, like, it doesn't fit with the norm.
Yeah, they're so wild looking, but they kind of just work for some reason.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah, I don't know. What were the consensus in the IG comments?
A lot of people didn't like it.
Yeah, a lot of people, I could see that.
But I feel like it's going to grow on people. It definitely did grow on me.
Maybe with a mellower colorway, they'll like it.
I like this colorway too.
I do too.
All right, wrapping things up, $125.
That's it, cheap.
That's pretty cheap, especially for the large volume Zoom unit and the nice materials. But yeah, is it a good performer? Yeah, I freaking love playing in this, man. These are super nice to play in. The only, there's a few things that I would change I didn't really like. The first is the weight. You know, I would have liked it to be a little bit lighter. Next is durability. The rubber, they need to, you know, definitely use a different type of rubber, because it's just, this is way too soft and not durable at all. And also another thing I would have changed is the court feel. Court feel, I really like to have a lot of court feel, so if the court feel was a little bit better, it would have been much better for me. But other than that, awesome shoe. And that's about it. And those weren't like anything major. But yeah, I really enjoyed playing these. These look super dope as well.
The price is right.
So yeah, definitely I recommend them. And I feel like a lot of people are going to, you know, enjoy playing these. You know, whatever position you are, you're gonna enjoy these. Other than that, awesome shoe. Go ahead and cop when they restock. But anyways, thank you guys for watching. We'll see you guys next one.
Later.